Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how you can trim multiple objects at once. Okay, so there was a question asked on the SketchUp forums, or I've recreated this, but basically what the person was trying to do was subtract these different spheres from this grid of, I assumed, wood. I'm going to show you how to do that in this video. Now, we'll start out by saying I'm not sure of any plugins that will do this in a more efficient way. They may exist. This way is going to be somewhat tedious, less tedious than if you were to do this one by one. But what you want to be sure to do when you do this is make sure you save the first thing, and even maybe even save a copy as, just so that you have a backup in case something happens. So the issue that you might be running into here is that I have this as a group. These are all, if I click into this, these are all separate. They're groups, they're not components, even though they're the same. I just quickly did this. But what happens when I try to use the solid objects here, so if I do select subtract, so I want to select first solid from the second. So let's say I want to get rid of one of these spheres. I would choose select, it lets me select this, and then I get a little two. But I get the X mark, like a little, you cannot do this. And it says not a solid for this guy. So if I click into this, all of these are separate groups, and that's why this isn't a solid. But this particular one, you can see when you get a solid, it'll give you a volume. All of these individually are solids. So what we need to do, and why you might want to back this up, is we need to make this one uniform solid. To do that, we're going to use the solid operation tools. This is going to take a little bit because there's a lot going on here, but just bear with me and we'll go through it. And eventually we're going to end up speeding this up because it's going to take a little bit of time. But you can actually do this in multiple steps depending on how fast your computer is. So it might be quicker for you than it is for me. It might be slower for you than it is for me. Okay, so I'm just going to start using this as a little reference. Copy this off to the side really quickly. I'm going to hit B for the paint bucket tool. Select a color. Let's choose a green. So this guy is going to have one capped edge. Now let me just measure and make sure this is correct. So this should be 1 foot. 1 foot. This should be 6. We want that to be actually 1 foot shorter because we just wanted it to be 5. Okay. So we have that. Just going to select all of this, make it a component. And then select this again, right click, make unique. Select all of it. And then we're just going to make this like a teal. And this guy will have no capped ends. So start here. This goes across 1 foot. And then this guy will rotate one of them. Choose them, put them there, times 9. We may need to just move off to the side a little bit. I'm just going to select all these and see how many I have. So I have 10. I'm going to do a 10 by 10 grid, so that works out. Move this over 5. Choose this, choose that, times 8. Select these, there should be 10. And then just double check my spacing between them. Should be 5. Yep. So that's good so far. Times 9. What do we want? Times 8. Do the same thing over here. Take this, rotate it up. Okay, so we have these guys across. Now what I want to do is select this, rotate it down, move it over, times 9. Okay, go to the top view. I have a quick a shortcut that I've set up just for that. So I'm going to just select these really quickly. I'm holding control just to get the selection. Okay, times 9. Yep. And then the same thing here, take this. Hitting Q to rotate. And move this down. Times 9. Now we'll check and make sure everything looks all right, and it does. So that's our bottom part. Now, just for reference, because I need this when I'm going up. I don't want this blue guy. So if I have a blue guy, which I do, unfortunately. Just check the end pieces really quick as I go through this to make sure there's no duplicates. I'm going to hit Control X here to get rid of those. Go to the top view. Now where I see the blues, I'm going to delete them, edit, paste in place, and that should be good. I just want to check that I didn't. So I must have done that when I rotated because these guys on the edge look fine. Take this guy, I'm going to copy him up, so I'm going to copy here, and then up an additional 5 feet, exactly where I want that, go to here, times 8, so, and then the rest of these middle ones are going to be exactly the same, so what I'm going to do is go to my max, let me just check and make sure that this is correct first, should be 10 of these. So I'm going to select my bottom pieces, go all the way up. And since I already have a reference, I'm just going to scale these in the reverse direction, -1, and come back down to here, and then I'll have duplicates there, so I'm just going to delete them. I'm going to hit save here just in case anything happens while I'm working through this next part. So I have these guys as references, but I won't need them for this. Maybe I'll use that first one just as a reference because it'll make things a little bit faster, I think. So I'm going to copy this guy up. I guess rotate him up. Move him to here. Same thing. Times 9. Choose the front view. This is where parallel projection is really helpful. If you're not using parallel projection, you might want to consider using that for this, just because when you move to like a side view, it's easier to select everything. Okay, so basically what we have here in the middle is going to be great for continuing to go up. So if I select all these minus that guy, and just double check my measurements here, 5 feet. So I'm selecting this guy. We're going to here times 9. So I'm not sure exactly what happened. Let me just check that there are 9 of these or 10. Yeah. Not sure what's happened there. But I'm just going to roll with it. Maybe I didn't move them at the right location. Front. The first time. Choose all those. Choose these guys. And then move them down. And that should be good. So now everything should be clean. Nice and clean how we want it. I'm going to just save this. And then what I'm going to do is select this. Group it. And then the smart thing here is to ungroup or to make a copy of it first. And then I'm going to hide that so it doesn't bog down everything. And then what I'm going to do is select this and explode. And explode it again. Now this could take some time. Basically everything's going to be stuck to each other after this happens. But this should be easier for the software to understand than unioning everything together. Okay, so we finished here. And now you can see everything is stuck to itself. When we make it a group, we have a volume, so that means that it's a solid, which is exactly what we wanted. And then we can come in here if we want. We can change back to the default. So what I'm going to do is hit B for the paint bucket tool and then choose Alt to select the default color. Right click, and it's going to color all those faces to be the default. I'm going to use this as a reference. Okay. Bring this in here. Just trying to make sure that I stay on that line. So I just made a copy. It makes it a little bit easier for me. Hide. So now, Control S to save, because when you're doing something like this intense, you just want to make sure that you're saving or saving a copy as at every sort of step of the way. Now, what I could do is I could union these together and then try subtracting it. For this, because I know it's going to be sort of an advanced operation, what I'm going to do is just try it one at a time, because I think it'll be best that way. If it doesn't work, then we will try it differently. But let's try this first. So I hit subtract there. I selected the one of the objects that I wanted to subtract from my geometry. So I selected that sphere first, or spheroid object, and then I selected my new grouped solid. It's going to take a little bit of time. And then once this operation finishes, then I'll move on to the next sphere. So you can see right there that operation finished. So again, because I got sort of the result that I was looking for, when I do control, we're gonna do a save a copy as, just in case. Save multiple two. You just save that copy. Again, subtract, select your first geometry that you want to subtract. The geometry you want to subtract of, then select the geometry you want to select from. You're going to get wait some time, and then we'll just go through this and we'll do each one, and then I'll show you the result. Okay, so our operations have finished, and you can see there's some floating bits here, so you might just want to come in and delete any floating geometry that you have. But overall, we have finished our operation, and we were able to get what we were looking for. If you guys have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask them in the comments down below, and share this video with your friends if you thought it was helpful. And as always, happy hacking.